I will text you that right now. Okay, bye-bye.
So, I've been thinking over everything you said to me, and you have every right to still be angry. So...
Oh, thank you so much for the validation, Tucker. I mean, honestly, I don't know what I would have done without it. Listen, I'm not angry with you, okay? I'm annoyed, but what I feel for you, like I said before, was indifference.
No, I don't buy that. I think that's a facade to cover up the pain you feel from what I did to you. You know that love like ours never dies.
Could you just get over yourself? For the record, and hear me out here, it's easy to stop loving somebody when they've repeatedly cheated on you. Not to mention you try to take away my family's company, Tucker. Are we really going to keep going over this again and again?
I keep coming back to that pivotal conversation we had when our relationship was falling apart, right? And Catherine urged you to come talk to me.
Okay, so we're going to keep talking about
this? Yes, we are. Okay. Yes, we are. And you said to me the only way we could stay together is if I was a different man, if I underwent some kind of miraculous change. But you weren't sure you believed in those kind of miracles anymore, right?
Yeah. So, you think the best way to revive my belief in miracles is to land your helicopter in my backyard? Genius.
Yeah, that was not the best decision I've ever made, and I've taken a lot of flack for it.
I bet you have.
And in hindsight... I'm glad you weren't there to see it as a grand gesture. It was kind of a flop. But I have changed.
Well, so since... you keep telling me. Yeah, I know.
Right. Talk is cheap. That's why I'm here. I would like the opportunity to show you I've changed. Take you to dinner, okay? Just the two of us. If after dinner you still feel the same way, you honestly want nothing to do with me, I swear I'll back off. Say